Hey everybody, I'm Justin with Excel Smith, where our goal is to build better Excel users. On this episode of Solutions, we'll learn how to build a custom dynamic array using two index formulas. The solution in this video combines two index formulas to build a custom array that can act as an input to another formula. All we need to build our equation is the index function. I've added the Microsoft support link for this formula in the description below. Let's jump in. Our data set consists of four columns: region, sales lead, product, and sales. We want a formula that lets us dynamically build an array using a subset of our overall data set. Column G contains the inputs that will be passed into our two index formulas to drive the range of our dynamic array. For the first parameter in each index formula, we will select the entire column for each heading in our data set. By selecting the entire column, we ensure that our custom array equation can flex if the number of rows in the dataset change. An alternative to selecting the entire column would be to convert the dataset into a table. One difference between the two approaches is that the rows in the example are the absolute rows of the worksheet. If you use a table, the rows are relative to the rows in the table following the header row. In other words, in this example, the starting row value in G2 will reference row 2 of the spreadsheet. However, if the data set were converted into a table, the value in G2 would reference the second row of the data following the header row, or row 3 of the worksheet. The logic of the formula will still work. You just need to ensure the values in the starting and ending row cells in column G properly reflect the desired rows of your data set. The second parameter of the index formula is the row where we want our custom range to begin. To allow for easy manipulation, we'll set this parameter equal to cell G2. The last parameter needed in the index formula is the column where we want our custom range to begin. Similar to the previous parameter, we will set this value equal to cell G4 in order to make updating easier. This formula currently just returns a single value located at the intersection of the second row and the third column, the values in cells G2 and G4. However, we want to establish a range. To continue building our equation, we need to enter a colon followed by a similar index formula to set the lower right cell of the range. Like the first index formula, we will set the first parameter of this index function to all four columns of our data set. The second parameter is set to the value in cell G3, and the last parameter is set to the value in cell G5. Since this is an array formula, we need to submit it by pressing Ctrl, Shift, and Enter. The results don't appear to be that exciting, as the equation appears to only return a single value. This is because Excel cannot display an array inside a single cell. However, if we evaluate the equation in the formula bar by pressing F9, we see the expected array results. The results include all of the values in the range C2 through D5, which is the intersection of rows 2 through 5 and columns 3 through 4. In the results, the commas denote moving to the next column, whereas the semicolons represent moving down to the next row. Let's press Escape to ensure we don't lose our equation. In order to see the results of our equation, we could use text join. By supplying our index equation as the third parameter in text join, the array parameter, we can see all of the values in the range C2 through D5. However, we lose the row separator that we had when we evaluated the equation in the formula bar. We can confirm that our formula contains the correct number of rows and columns by using the rows and columns functions. To use these formulas, we simply pass in the index equation as the only parameter. In this example, we see that our array contains four rows, which is what we expected. This corresponds to rows 2 through 5, the values in cells G2 and G3. Our columns equation confirms that the array consists of two columns, columns 3 and 4, which is set by the values in cells G4 and G5. In addition to returning the number of rows and columns, we can combine text join with the row and column functions to see which rows and columns are contained within our new array. To do this, we simply set the third parameter of text join to be either a row or column function containing our index equation. Unlike the formulas to determine the number of rows and columns, these text join equations must be submitted as an array formula by using Ctrl, Shift, and Enter to ensure the row and column functions in the third parameter return the correct results. In our example, the results of these text join equations confirm that our custom array contains rows 2 through 5 and columns 3 through 4. By creating the helper cells in column G, we can easily modify the array being built by the two index formulas. As we modify these values, we see the results in column J update to reflect the newly created array. Using two index formulas to create a dynamic array isn't something that's terribly useful on its own. However, it can provide great flexibility in the right situation as an input to another formula. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and tell your friends. Also, leave a comment below if you have an example where you've needed a dynamically generated array to use inside another formula. Thanks for watching!